Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com. Today I'm going to show you the process. It's called lapping your valves. So whenever you're having to rebuild the head or you're replacing the valves, this is going to be a necessary part of it to make sure that the surfaces line up correctly. Only need a few tools in the head itself, so let me go grab those and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, basically there's only one type of tool that you need to get this little project done. It's a lapping tool. It actually has a rubber cup on the end of it. So that basically will hold it in place where you can run it back and forth. The other piece you're going to need is a valve grinding or lapping compound. You can pick it up at most any local auto parts store. Third thing, need to pick up a little tube of Prussian blue. I like to check what progress I've made by actually marking the edge of the valve with ink, and that actually will transfer it to the valve or from the valve onto the seat. Other than that, that's really all you need to get this done. And the chances are this is going to be really simple. Everything should line up fairly well and have a nice groove in there. What we're going to do is coat one of these before it's been lapped with a Prussian blue. And what's that? It's a type of dye that actually shows you where metal is making contact. So let's take one of our exhausts and we're just going to lightly coat it. Go ahead and pop it in, and then we'll be able to see where all it's hitting. All right, one of two ways you can do this. Either use one of these little, I guess you call it, lapping tools that actually attach to the valve on the side via a suction cup, or just a quarter inch piece of fuel line. Just slide it over the valve stem on the other side, and we just turn it back and forth a few times. All right, let's pop her out. All right, we're looking for a consistent blue impression all the way around, roughly the width of this tip of this pick tool. And that is pretty much exactly what we're looking at. That actually looks really good. So it's not gonna take hardly any lapping at all to get this in there correctly. So let's get that clean back off and then we'll start the lapping process. All right, grab our valve. It doesn't take a lot of this stuff. This is basically just an abrasive in a grease base, if you want to call it that. All right, and now that we're going to be putting a little bit of pressure on the stem itself, let's go ahead and just put a little bit of oil on it. So the last thing I want to do is scar that surface. Now you want to be very careful as you're doing this not to let any of that material get onto the valve stem. That would be bad. Now when we start this off, it's going to sound a little gritty, and that's okay, that's what we want. But as I go further and further, it pushes more of that out of the way and it'll start to, you won't hear it as much. See how it goes away? Now, just lift it up a little bit. Get some more of that material drawn back in. Just like that. All right, let's go and pull her out. And that should take care of it. Now we want to make very sure that we clean out all of that material, because that would be catastrophic to say the least. Typically, on one that is as close as this is, 4 to 5 times, starting at the beginning, waiting for it to be quiet, that's about all it's going to take. And just for fun, we'll put the Prussian blue back on there again, then take one more peek. Oh yeah, nice blue line all the way around. That one's ready to go. Now, all I gotta do is do the same thing for all the other ones. Am I gonna go back and check it with the Prussian blue again? Nah, probably not. It's just gonna take a little bit of lapping compound about 4 or 5 times with either this tool or that rubber hose. And then we'll start actually installing the valves once that's done. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps it up. Well, listen, if you need a new set of valves for your machine, come see us at PartZilla.com and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments, just leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.